And from the News Sentinel newsroom, I'm Vinnie Lopes, joined alongside by high school football guru Justin Kenny, and we're here talking about the new brackets that just came out for the state football postseason. And we're looking at Class 2A here, the Sectional 27. And Justin, it's the small schools 2A, but this is probably one of the more intriguing brackets for most people here in the Fort Wayne area.
Yeah, definitely. And a tougher bracket than previous seasons. Obviously, Churubusco moved into there last year, but Oak Hill is traditionally strong. Madison Grant, traditionally strong. Bluffton's gotten better. Elwood's having a good year. So this is a lot tougher sectional than it has been the last couple years.
All right, so let's start breaking down this bracket. And let's start at the top as we have Elwood going up against two presidents in Madison Grant. who gets this win?
I like Elwood. Elwood has kind of impressed me this year. They knocked off Eastbrook. That's kind of when they caught my attention, because Eastbrook is such a great power down in the CIC. So I'm going to take Elwood. It's a rematch of a regular season game. Elwood wins that one over Madison Grant.
Okay, now moving on to the rest of the quarterfinals. Oak Hill and Churubusco. Do the children of the turtle pull this one out?
I think Churubusco wins this game, but a couple of 7-1 teams. Oak Hill is no slouch. They play a really tough schedule down there in the CIC. I know Bud Osmond, he's a great coach over at Oak Hill, but it's a long drive up to Busco, and I think the key, obviously, with Busco is running the football. They should be able to run the football enough to beat Oak Hill.
All right, now looking at the bottom of the bracket, you have Bluffton going up against the favorite name to say in the Fort Wayne area, Blake Blaker and Eastside. Who gets this win?
I like Bluffton in this game. I like Casey Colkman over there doing great things. 5-3 Bluffton. They're in a position to have their most wins in a long time. I think they get another one of their first wins, I think, in a long time in the postseason even. So Tigers move on.
All right, now looking at the final quarterfinal match, but definitely the one that most people in the state are going to have their eyes on, Bishop Luers going for their fourth consecutive state championship. And they're facing a pretty decent team in Woodlan that's been on the rise this year.
You know, Sherwood Haydock came from Harding, went to Woodlan, said, you know what, it's going to take a couple years for us to start getting better. We've seen them start getting better this season, late season. They pounded South Adams last week. Nobody saw that coming, 37-0. So they are improving, but they are a far, far cry from Bishop Luers. I don't care if Bishop Luers has 3 losses, 5 losses, 7 losses. They have the most talent in this bracket. They have the most talent in the North in 2A. Bishop Luers wins.
Okay, so now looking at the semifinal matchups, Elwood, Churubusco, who gets this one?
I think Busco wins this one again based on their run game. Nicodemus goes off again. Could be close, but Elwood, while they're 6-2, are good. I question their schedule, their strength of schedule. I question Busco's as well, but I think Busco, if they win in the trenches, they win.
Well, and you've been hearing it now throughout the start of the season. Churubusco wants their chance at Bishop Luers. So does it happen? Does Bishop Luers get through Bluffton pretty easily?
It does. Luers gets through Bluffton pretty easily, setting up that championship matchup.
Okay, so it's the championship matchup. Two teams that, in many ways, they have some similarities on offense with the way they love to run the football. You're going to have a great defensive matchup in Jordan Nicodemus, the running back for Churubusco, going up against that great Bishop Luers defense. But who winds up winning this sectional championship?
You know, a couple weeks ago before Busco played Culver, I could say maybe Busco goes out and gives Luers a chance and gives them a game. But they lose to a Culver team who is good but not great. And Culver has a lot less athletes, a lot less speed than Luers. Luers can go sideline to sideline quicker than anything that Churubusco has seen. Nicodemus can run, but he's going to look like he's running through cement when he plays as Bishop Luers. I think Bishop Luers wins this game. It could be close for a half. Knights pull away, win a sectional championship.
Right. And Bishop Luers has 3 losses on the year, but to all high-quality teams.
Yeah, and everybody forgets in 2009, they were 4-5 in the regular season, won the state championship. So the regular season does not mean much for 2A Luers.
Yeah, well, if the run for Luers is going to happen, they're going to make it to a fourth straight state championship. It's going to start in the sectionals. This is Justin's prediction on how he thinks it's going to break out, but you're going to get your opportunity to say how it should happen by going to News-Sentinel and participating in the News-Sentinel Bracket Challenge. Well, that's going to do it for us here in the studio. That's Justin Kenny. I'm Vinnie Lopes.